Now we are ready to draft the front bodice. The first thing to do is to draw the chest line. The same way we have the back line for the back bodice. They draw the chest line. And the chest line is 4 cm above the bust line. If you have a grid ruler, you can place it this way. 4 cm. And draw above. Let me do it this way for the purpose of those that will not have a grid ruler. So you can place your ruler on 4 cm and mark it this way. You get it. Mark it at two different points. Then draw a straight line from the center front. From the center front, you draw a straight line this way. And you label it chest line. Don't forget, this is the bust line. When we're doing that of the back. Then the next thing is to draw the neck line. And you know, if you can remember the width of the neck line for the back, we use 7 cm. So we are marking 7 cm too here. And you come down by 7 cm. Also, you can use 7 to 8 cm depending on the size you are working with. So you can complete this block. Most times in pattern drafting, when we have to draw a curve, you draw something like a rectangular block first this way, and you put your ruler like this to draw a curve. Okay, so this is NP, that is neck point. Also NP here, neck point. So the next thing is to draw the shoulder. So how do we draw the shoulder? You come 12 cm from the neck point to get the shoulder slant, 12 cm. On this 12 cm mark, you come down by 5.5 cm. 5.5 cm, this point here. If you have your grid ruler, you just straightforward, you just place your ruler this way, 12, and you mark 5.5. So this point, you draw it to the neck point. You extend it beyond the neck point, because that's where we want to put our shoulder measurement. So the next thing to do is to mark, to put our chest measurement on the chest line. And if you can remember, our chest measurement is 38 cm. And half of 38 cm is 19. We divided into two because this is like half of the front. Remember, we drafted half of the back too. So half of 38 is 19 cm. So you place your ruler this way from 0 to 19 cm. So to plan out that the same way we did for the back, you locate the middle of this 19 cm, the midpoint again, and that is 9.5. So this 19 cm that we mark here, you call it provisional chest point. You see why it is provisional. Provisional chest point. So this is the midpoint for planning of our dart. So you can take the same measurement on the waistline. This is the waistline that we draw right across to the front when we are drafting that of the back. So you can mark the same 9.5 rather on the waistline, so that you can draw a straight line to cut the shoulder line. This line will be used as a guideline to plan the dart. So that is why I'm using a dash line. So we have our dart and our guideline. So from the guideline, you measure 2 cm. That is Natalie Bray method. It's not compulsory. You can change it. If you remember when we drafted, when we put the dart for the back, you can put it at the midpoint. It's not really compulsory. So you can put 2 cm. You get it? 2 cm. So from this 2 cm, you measure the size of the dart. And the size of our dart is 7 cm. So from here, you have 7 cm. Can you get that? So how do you now draw the dart? You draw the dart to a point 2 cm below the bust line. This is the bust line. On this guideline, mark 2 cm. Can you see that? 2 cm below the bust line. So that is where you draw your dart. So we want to complete our dart this way. Can you see that? That is our dart. So the next thing to do is to mark the final shoulder seam. You know, we left this line unfinished. So how do you get the final shoulder seam? That will be the shoulder measurement plus that of the dart. If you remember, our shoulder is 12.5 plus that or 7 cm, that is 19.5. 19.5. Okay, so if you notice, if you look at this dart, you see that it has taken some part of the chest measurements, and we have to replace that. If not, it will be shortened, it will be tight on you. So you measure whatever the dart has taken up. This is about 2 cm, so you measure the 2 cm back here. You increase this place by 2 cm. You see that? So this place is the final chest point. So you see why we cut this one the provisional chest point the other time. So the next thing is to draw this final chest point to the shoulder point. This is shoulder point SP. So you draw the shoulder point to the final chest point with a straight line. So from this point, the final chest point, you drop a perpendicular to the bust line. Perpendicular means the line must be 90 degrees, must be straight. So you can pick a line or a grid ruler, make sure it's straight with the line and drop it. So perpendicular means this angle is 90 degrees, that's perpendicular. So now we want to draw our armhole. These two lines will serve as a guide to draw our armhole. So from here to here, you locate the midpoint. Midpoint means middle. Here is about 12 cm, so the midpoint will be 6 cm. On this midpoint, you go in by 1 cm. So if I place my ruler this way, 1 to 2 cm will give me 1 cm this way. So you use the curved part of your ruler. You have 3 reference points. 1, 2, 3. That's the first point we are joining together. So you place your ruler this way. Make sure the 3 points, yeah, we have the 3 points now. So draw this way, this point, and to this point. So we have to complete with the underarm point. So from point 3, you draw your cuff to the underarm point. When you are drawing, make sure that this place, you can choose a point here, should be 1.5 cm. 1.5 cm. This is 1.5 cm. So make sure that your curve passes through that point. See it, and it can dip a little this way. So you have your arm hole. So to complete the front bodice, the same way we came in by 2 cm for the waistline, for the waist shaping, you can also go in by 2 cm. 2 cm, and you draw this to the you connect this point to the underarm point. You see that? Okay, then you can also draw your waist dart by planning. Natalie Bray method said 3 cm dart on both for the front, so that would be 1.5. That's one, this is 1.5, another 1.5, that would be 3. So how long will the dart be? There is what we call the true bust line. People that are familiar with freehand, that's where you call the bust point. That's the highest level on the bust. And the bust, true bust line is 4 cm from the bust line. So let me draw that. 4 cm. You can see that. So I'm connecting that. 4 cm. So this is 4 cm from the bust line. Chest line to 4 cm above. So this is true bust line. So your dart must not touch the true bust line. The same thing when you are doing freehand and you want to do a contoured bodice, your dart does not reach the true bust point. So you come down from the true bust line 2 cm. And you see that 2 cm. So you complete your dart by drawing the dart legs. So this is 1.5 cm. 1.5 cm. That is 3 cm. But this is not like a hard and fast rule. You can check that depending on your size. If you take the waist measurement and you see that you still have to do some adjustments, you can do that. I think you'll be able to get that further when we do the create my wardrobe. That's the proper online course. So you may be wondering, what is this space for? What I told you when we were starting, that we added 5 cm to the length to waist for construction purpose. So the waistline of the human figure is not this straight. It somehow dips at the front. So that is why we left this space. So this is what we are going to do. At the center front. At the center front. This is the center front line. You know? So you come down by 1 cm. at the dart legs too, you come down by 1 cm, 1 cm. At the side seam, you come down by 0.5 cm for the front and also 0.5 cm for the back. Then you leave the center back just the way it is. So how do we connect the points? So from the center back, you connect to the 0.5 cm mark. Then 0.5 cm to the 1 cm of the first dart leg. Then you connect this with a straight line. So this is how the waistline should look like. So you can extend your dart legs. Before we complete the draft final, there's something they call the dart jog. Yeah. So if you notice that, let's measure the length of the dart. Here we have 23 cm, and the other length of the dart is what, 24.5 cm. So if you bring them together, you see that this will be longer than this. So how do you correct that? You can fold at this line, at this point, you see that, then bring the longer length, fold along the longer length and bring over the shorter length this way. You see, you can see the difference, it's really obvious here. So and you now draw your shoulder seam all over from the neck point to the shoulder point. You then use your tracing wheel to trace out this line so that it reflects on the folded portion this way. Okay, so you can open your drafts. So you can open your drafts and use your ruler. You can see the points. You can see the points here. So you complete this and this way. So when you are cutting out, you cut along this line after adding the allowance. So here we have our basic bodice, the back bodice and the front bodice. And if you remember when we are drafting the back bodice, if you want these same lines to be at the same point, whatever you have from neck point to the first dart leg, let's see what we have here. This is about 5 cm. You make sure it's the same on the back. And you can also do the dart jog for the back by folding on this line. So you have something just a little way up this way. So here you have your basic bodice, this front bodice, and this is the back bodice.